3 days ago, at exactly 0600, because that is really not the time, on February 5, because that is really not the date, this freighter, which shall be nameless, sailed from a certain far eastern port. Its destination, the port of Los Angeles, Wilmington, California. This is fact. At exactly 15 minutes before the freighter reaches a point inside the breakwater for quarantine inspection, directly in the path of the ship's course, a man is sighted and rescued at sea. Step number one in a daring scheme. This is Accomplice A. His story simple. A small fishing boat sunk, no ship-to-shore equipment aboard to send out an SOS. It could happen to anyone. A lucky thing, the freighter came along. The next step is also very simple, routine. The health officer goes out to meet the ship. The anchor is dropped. Yellow flag goes up, a warning to all of the ships at sea that quarantine has been declared. This flag stays up until the vessel is cleared. Nobody leaves the ship, nobody comes aboard. Nobody, that is, except the health officer. This is Accomplice B. Accomplice B goes about examining the ship, inspecting the crew for any communicable diseases, when he himself feels suddenly ill. He manages to complete his inspection and clear the vessel. But now he begins feeling worse. The incident actually is not out of the ordinary, nor even too surprising. Accomplice B is a known diabetic. He wears the special identification tag worn by all diabetics in case they are ever found in shock. I am a diabetic. If found unconscious, please give me sugar. Accomplice B assures the captain that he'll be all right if he can just rest until the ship docks. The captain will send the launch back to port without him. B prepares himself, checks the time, while Accomplice A clocks himself out for the next planned move. Accomplice A now puts the scheme into operation. He creates a diversion. Smoke. Fire aboard the ship. The fire detector flashes to life. Shows where the smoke is coming from. An alarm is sent throughout the ship. The prearranged signal Accomplice B has been waiting for. He puts the second stage of the scheme into operation. No faking this time. He gives himself a shot. A deliberate overdose of insulin, which in a very few moments now will throw him into a severe state of induced insulin shock. Yes, very real this time. And all the while, Accomplice A moves through the ship, making his way clear down into the hold, directly to the special cargo storage container. Thank you. Accomplice A does his job well. Works back to the captain's cabin with his prize. And when B is carried off the ship, the prize will go with him. It is all beautifully planned, timed right down to the last second. The ambulance reaches the dock. Accomplice C, the nurse, rushes aboard ship with the ambulance doctor. His diagnosis? Insulin shock. You can't trick this. You can't fool a trained eye, a trained mind. The victim must be gotten to the hospital at once. Accomplice C knows exactly what to do. But exactly. It's almost all too simple, too easy. This little package, U.S. Army medical supply, under U.S. government bond, $250,000 of therapeutic value on its way back into the United States, passed on to Accomplice D, who gets the stuff to the boys on top, who cut it, push it, throw it on the open market. The sky is the limit. Ounces of big, white, fluffy, happy clouds. Guaranteed delivery for just a few 3-cent stamps. Safe and sound. After all, who doesn't trust the mails?
I ran out of money. Had to play that last part myself.
Not bad, Jordan. Only thing, you didn't serve popcorn. I like popcorn when I see a movie.
You change those two words around, Mr. Quantrill, I'll keep you in popcorn for the rest of your life.
You're a talented fella, Jordan. It took courage to do what you did. Spend your last buck on a lot of make-believe.
Well, you don't get security without investment.
So you hired yourself a boat and a bunch of actors and you made a picture. Anything went wrong, you could do it over again. But how about when it comes to the real thing? The right people. The real boat. The real heist.
I've got my finger on the right people, Mr. Quantrill. I've got the cargo storage plan of the real boat. And I know just where to put my hands on the real thing. Now, your only risk is putting up the money to buy those people. Mine's to make sure the real job comes off right the first time. Now, anything goes wrong, why, keep the film. You've got connections. You could sell it for a television series.
When? When, Jordan?
When what?
There's a boat dock.
Now, Mr. Quantrill, next you'll be asking me what's the name of the boat and who my people are. What hold the stuff's in. Now, I tell you all that, Mr. Quantrill, why, you wouldn't need me, would you? You know, you ought to add another word to that. Trust.
What do you say, Paula?
It'll work, Harry.
If Paula says it'll work, it'll work.
But what?
Don't get touchy, Mr. Jordan. I like your whole idea. I think it's cute. It's adorable. I think Harry and his friends will make a lot of money. I was only wondering. Maybe it's just a woman's intuition. But the nurse, who's she going to be?
Oh, the nurse. Well, if I said it'd be just like having your own mother on the job, the nurse couldn't be any closer.
My old lady fed me to the cops when I was a kid.
It's like Harry just said, Mr. Jordan. I think he should protect his investment.
What is it, Paula?
Well, if I were that nurse, you'd be sure Mr. Jordan got that package to mail to you. Wouldn't you, Harry?
Paula, it's like she's got two heads on her shoulders. One of them for just thinking. Paula's a nurse, you got yourself a deal.
There's only one thing I don't like about it. I didn't happen to think of it.
Well, I'll buy the drinks. We'll discuss the details later.
Mr. Jordan. I feel so lazy. Would you help me on with my shoes, please? Welcome home.
Oh, sisters under the skin. Paula, Jan. Jan, Paula.
Ever been in California before? Nope. On a clear date and taking the whole city. Oil wells, new convertibles, nightclubs, even diamond bracelets and jewelry store windows. I'm sure you'll enjoy every minute of it. So old-fashioned. Fed, little fellow. Just to keep the record straight, don't let that loose. You're supposed to be a nurse. This whole flat rents for $70 a month. Your salary's supposed to be $100 a week. I'll remember.
It'll do.
I have everything arranged. I'm on vacation. You're a friend. You're to take my place for a week. You show up tomorrow night, they'll be expecting you. Next, Eddie Mason, the intern that drives the ambulance.
He's not in on this. Works the night shift and weekends to sweat out an extra buck. Now, the emergency call will come through to the docks the morning the freighter pulls in. Simple as that.
Your credentials, a first aid book. Oh, I'll get by. There isn't any part of the anatomy I don't know, even with my eyes closed.
I think I can brief her on the rest.
She the one as close to you as your own mother?
Now, let's not be psychological, Paula.
What you told Harry.
Pretend you're my mother.
Now who's getting psychological, Jordan?
Let's put it this way. Let's not be greedy. Let's you and me just try to concentrate on Harry's investment. For the time being.
Is that all I'm allowed to concentrate on? What's the matter, Jordan? Don't you like my other head?
I like mine. I don't want to die thinking of Harry having its stuff hanging over the mantle of his fireplace.
Harry's a pig and you know it. You saw how fast he let me go when he thought he wasn't going to get all that was coming to him.
When you thought.
So soon. Better see a doctor, Jordan. You've got a low blood count.
You're wrong, Paula. I've got no blood. Now get this through your head, both of them. I didn't ask for you. I inherited you. And my only vision of you nights when I crawl into bed is you handing over that package.
Next, you'll be wanting a loyalty oath.
Not me. Harry. Better put your shoes on.
Thank you. nuts. You'll get used to it. They get out of the way. Well, sometimes. How come something like you picked something like this for a career?
Drive for Pocketies. You've been asking me about me since I came on the job. Next thing I know, you'll be asking me up to your place to see your etching. Of an operation.
My place? If I had room for an etching, I would invite you up.
Better come over here first. The mother and father, they're over there, both dead.
The poor kid. The poor little kid.
There's nothing we can do here. Give me a hand with it. None of that.
He's dead. He hadn't even started to live. He's dead.
That's right, he is dead. Nothing you or I could do about it either. 5 minutes from now, or 5 seconds, we're liable to get another call. This time to pick up somebody else who will live. Only he may be so mangled up for life that he should be dead. And then you'll ask yourself, where's the justice?
Please, Eddie, do you have to talk like that now?
Don't let life or death rub off on you if this is what you want to do. You should know that.
But he was only a child. A baby.
I'm sure he was just a baby, but... and no favor. Hey, what are you? A nurse or a woman?
Both. Because I wear a starch uniform. Does that make me any less a woman?
I'll get you some hot coffee.
Thank you.
There's your Aladdin's lamp, Herbie. Go on, open it. Feel it. Rub your hands over it. There's a genie inside. It'll put you on any ship you want. Sail you all over the seven seas, take you any place you want to go. You can start living, Herbie. You can be free. Sure. You can have anything you want. Anything money can buy. I guess I had you figured wrong.
Did I say no? Don't be a genie giver, my friend. Hey, Chiquita, bring me and my genie friend another drink.
Now, take it easy, Herbie. You'll be having to take another shot of insulin as a chaser in a minute.
Aren't you the lucky one? And isn't it ironical that I grow up to be a health officer? Me? Poor, sick, diabetic Herbert Fane. Me. Sick as a dog, Herbie. A health officer. And aren't you the lucky one the day I collapse and go into shock? And the call goes just to the right emergency hospital. Now, who figures he's got himself just the right thing at the right time?
What's your message, Herbie?
Everybody's got different tastes. Some like them thin, some like them fat. Now, you take this little genie here. I think he's too thin. I like nice fat genies.
Sure. I'll see that he puts on more weight.
It's kind and generous, my friend. How about the drink?
Sure, sure.
You and I are staying close together, little genie. From now on, no more dreams. No more dreams to keep you awake, feeling drained, empty, alone. Now on, you're gonna change all that, aren't you, little genie?
Who are you? You pull me out of bed and bring me down here and start beating me up?
Boy, made up your mind yet?
You're crazy. I don't know who you are, but you're crazy.
I don't know who you are, but I sure found out.
Take a lot of convincing.
Change your mind, butcher boy, or you're gonna scorch. You're gonna scorch to a crisp.
I won't do it. I won't do it. I won't do it.
Sister. You got a good memory, butcher boy. And Helen's sister, she's very cooperative. She hates you.
And then he turned around and he killed that love. With his own two hands, he destroyed it and left her dead inside. Like a tree with roots ripped and torn. He told her surgery was the only way. Now she's dead.
Don't go yet, butcher boy. I want you to hear all of it.
The police know how it happened. The autopsy proved that. She made her mistake, and she paid for it. But he's still walking. walking around free somewhere.
Yeah. You're going to pay too much for blood. The way you killed her. Your kind of surgery. That's the dirtiest kind of murder.
No, please. I've been eating myself alive ever since. I've paid.
I tried to pay. I looked yesterday. From one end of the room to the other. There was no trace.
I'll make it up.
I got another tape just like that, Butcher Boy. Same voice, same words, same sister. I just remember everything I told you. Where to be, when to be there. Butcher Boy.
All right. I'll do it. All over town. I've been trying to find you all night. I need help. Please, Daddy, I need help. I'm in trouble.
So?
I need help.
I'm not your mother.
Please, I'm in terrible shape. I've got to have help.
You just come off the farm. What kind of cure they give you there?
It was all right. I kicked it. Something happened. Something personal.
Don't ever do that.
Sick.
You're a sick risk. Keep their eyes on guys like you. Got their bloodhounds roaming around, ready to give out one loud bark the minute they smell you going back on the stuff. That makes me hot. And I got to dig in the sewers and stay there till things cool.
That won't happen. You can trust me.
Won't happen. You can trust me.
Please, Daddy. Got to have some.
Shut up. I want to enjoy this.
Bail me out.
Must be sick one. To get well twice as much.
All right.
You got it with you?
Yes.
Put it in the napkin.
Private Fay. Huh? No, it's the Kobe, yes, out of Yokohama, berth 24. I'm just going there now to clear from quarantine. That's quite all right. No trouble at all.
Hey, you all right?
Who? What'd you say?
You don't look so good, Mr. Fay. You sure you're not sick?
This analysis I just ran showed a big change.
Well, is that good or bad?
Good. Your blood sugar level shot way up. I want you off all insulin for a week. We'll see what happens.
You what?
Just cut out taking your insulin shots, Mr. Fay. But what, Mr. Fay?
I don't understand. What happens if I do take a shot?
Well, as I said, if your condition keeps improving as indicated, insulin could throw you in shock again. There's one danger. The strain could produce a heart attack. But you don't have those worries now. You're one of the lucky ones.
Yeah. I'm one of the lucky ones.
Just a minute.
Wow, you are stuck.
Well, help.
Now, careful now. A girl can split her clavicle trying to squeeze herself into anything this way.
Don't get personal.
I'm just being clinical.
Thanks.
Anytime.
Anytime what?
Anytime you feel like splitting your clavicle again, it'd be a pleasure to help. Come on, let's see.
Oh, Eddie, you shouldn't have spent all that money.
Oh, don't worry. I'll collect your share. I'm proud, but I'm practical. Plates, please. Ham sandwiches. Ew. They're beginning to give me a neurosis.
And what's wrong with ham sandwiches?
For the poor people.
So pretend the caraway seeds are caviar.
Your champagne, Miss Nightingale. God bless. Delicious. From contented cows since 1926. One of the best years, of course.
Oh, definitely.
Now, some people prefer skim instead of homogenized. And then there's the people who like pure pasteurized. Now, personally, I get my kicks from straight alcohol with just a dash of peach flavoring.
Oh, you fool.
Paula? Do you think I can make it?
You'll make it, Eddie. You'll make it good. I know you will.
Sometimes I wonder. And everything inside me starts flipping. Big responsibility there. This watching over other people's lives. Maybe I'm just trying to talk myself out of it now. I don't know. But if I starve enough, maybe I'll change my mind. I don't want to settle for being one of the charm boys on the better side of town, running a prescription palace. Now, there's a big shortage of these in the world, and I want to use them. They're all I know how to think with.
Good, strong hands, Eddie. Don't ever be afraid to use them.
You know, I got so wrapped up, I forgot to tell you the good news. They're going to let me assist at surgery at the clinic tomorrow.
Oh, that's
wonderful.
This big worry speech I just made. I guess maybe I'm a little scared. Something? Your friend Jan, her letting you fill in for her while she's gone, it's the best vacation she ever had.
I hope I'm not breaking anything up.
I was just getting ready for work, if it isn't important.
Just passing by.
I'll wait for you downstairs.
I'll be right down, Eddie.
Cozy twosome? Hey, that Eddie. Nice looking boy.
What are you doing, playing watchdog for Harry?
I don't go on the defensive, Paula. Harry's my angel, but your private life is your own. The day after tomorrow. Saturday morning at 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock, the boat's due to dock. That emergency call will come through in plenty of time. Now, after that, after it's all over, before you go east, then I'd like to congratulate you. Sorry about the other night, Stanley. Pushing around like that. Sometimes we all have to do things we don't like to do.
I know.
No hard feelings?
No.
Good, I'll make it up to you like I promised. After it's all over. Here. Got everything fixed in your mind about tomorrow? Got the boat layout clear? The cargo storage plan?
I burned it, like you said.
Well, that's it then, Stanley. You, unlock that stuff, get it where it's supposed to go. You're just like unlocking a prison door for yourself. Walk out a free man. Ellen's sister's voice, it's all yours. And you, I never saw you before in my life. Don't lose that key, Stanley. Now, if I'd been you standing there looking at me, I don't know whether I would have jumped or pushed.
Mr. Natus of Western Pharmaceutical is here to see you.
Who?
Mr. Natus.
Oh, yes, I have him come in.
You can come in now, Mr. Natus.
Mr. Fay. I thought I'd come by and wish you luck. You've Very lucky fellow, Herbie.
Say what you have to say, then get out.
Now, Herbie, is that the way to talk? You know, ever since I first saw you, I've been feeding your genie, fattening him up. And I'd say by tomorrow night when he comes to see you, he should be just about your size. A nice, fat little genie.
You finished?
Relax, Herbie. You look a little pale. Now get to bed early tonight. I want you to be fresh and full of vitality tomorrow so you can do a good job. I'm counting on it. Oh, I almost forgot. It's for you. Compliments of Western Pharmaceutical.
The other night. The man who was
here. I don't want to know about him.
I've got to tell you.
I don't want to hear.
It's not what you think.
Look, Paula, we're not kids anymore. I don't care. I love you.
I've got to tell you.
Well, maybe at first when we first walked in. I was a little hurt.
Listen to me.
No, I won't listen. What you were yesterday and day before that, it doesn't matter. Tomorrow's I'm interested in. You and me and tomorrow.
What about tomorrow, Eddie? I've got to tell you.
Don't tell me. I'll tell you.
Tell me what, Eddie?
That I love you. Things to be good with us, Paula. Good the right way. If you don't mind ham on rye for a couple of centuries, I want to marry you. No, don't say anything now. I want you to be sure, awfully sure. Because for a long time, things won't come easy. I don't want you ever to be sorry.
I wanted to pack now, to be ready to get out after tomorrow.
Can't wait to hurry back to Harry, huh? Loyalty.
Oh.
That's what I like, loyalty. Smart, loyal, Paula. Got her heart and soul wrapped up in only one thing, Harry. And Harry's investment. Doing everything she can to protect Harry's investment. Isn't that right, Paula? Sure, sure, that's right. You even said so yourself, remember? If I was that nurse, you'd be sure Mr. Jordan got that package to mail to you, wouldn't you, Harry? You know what I think? I'll tell you what I think. I think you took your shoes off. Only this time, you thought you could step out of them and run.
No, Jordan. Eddie doesn't know anything, not about you, me, tomorrow, anything.
Yeah, Eddie, huh? Yeah, it had to be Eddie. I thought I saw him in your eyes the other night when I looked at you, but I couldn't be sure. Came by tonight to set things straight for tomorrow, and I saw his car outside, and I waited. Yeah. And I see him now, just by looking at you.
All right.
I was taking to leave. Now, alone. Eddie asked me to marry him.
Congratulations. Not the kind I'd planned to give you. We'll do till something better comes along.
You don't believe anything honest could hit people, do you? You couldn't understand why I had to leave Eddie, why I couldn't marry him.
I'll tell you what I understand. I understand the weeks and months I'd waited for tomorrow to come, the plans I'd made, the sweating. Yeah, even the prayers I prayed that nothing would go wrong. I'll tell you something else. I begged, borrowed, and grabbed every penny I could get my hands on to promote your Harry. I killed a man after he gave me what I wanted. I blackmailed another man to let him save his own life. I used another man's life to let him live his life. I even loved a woman. I did all that just for tomorrow.
Have your tomorrow, Jordan. But let me out. Let me get out. Get away from here.
Yeah, wouldn't that be smart?
I love Eddie. I love him enough to get out of his life, to stay out.
Then I believe you. But what about tomorrow? Suppose you wake up with a conscience.
No. No, Jordan. No one will ever know. I won't tell anyone. I won't tell. I won't tell. I won't tell.
That's right, Paula. You won't tell anyone. Forgive my allergy. People with a conscience.
Said you were going to call last night. Or maybe you've been too busy.
I want you to go to the hospital tomorrow morning, in her place. Mason asked any questions? You don't know anything.
Why mustn't I know anything?
She called you. Said you couldn't make it.
That doesn't tell me where you've been or why you haven't seen me.
Look, I'll be down at the docks myself. Be sure you get that stuff to me before you take off in the ambulance with Faye. Take it from me on board ship when you go to the cabin.
Is she tired, darling? Doesn't like to get up so early in the morning? Or maybe she's just gone to bed.
You've got a suspicious nature.
That's right, I have. And suddenly your whistle is off key.
I don't think so. See how this sounds.
Oh, darling, darling. I've missed you so. She didn't say anything at all to you?
Nothing.
And you were with her last night?
Yeah. I still don't get it. What'd she tell you?
She called. She said she wouldn't be on the job today, tomorrow, farewell, period.
Just like that?
Just like that.
She didn't say why, where she'd be, or where she was going?
She didn't say.
She did a phoner last night after I left. I didn't get any answer. I tried a few minutes later, still no answer.
What time was that? Well,
about 2:30 this morning.
This fellow we picked up before you boarded seemed to be suffering from severe exposure.
Mind having a look at him?
Yes, I'll check him before I leave.
Well, you better pour this into you. You'll shove your insides loose.
I'm getting so cold. I need something.
Now drink your tea. It'll make you feel better.
Please. You've got to help me. I need something.
Yeah, sure. Sure, sir. Sure you want to have a drink? I shipped aboard some beautiful stuff just before we cleared the last port.
No, thanks. Next time. Now, what about this man you wanted me to see?
What's the matter?
I don't know. I feel funny.
Anything I can do?
Must be one of my spells. It'll pass. If I could just lay down for a while.
We'll stay aboard till we dock. I'll send the tender back.
Thanks. Now, if you'll help me off my coat.
Well, yeah. Mr. Clay, I just used my bunk.
Thank you.
Here, take a sip of this. The man we picked up on the raft, he's violent. He's headed for the hole.
I'm sick. Take your pick, Doc. A dead one or a raving one.
You ready, Mason?
Yeah, just came over to the gate for you.
What goes on? What do you want with me?
Relax, miss. Where's Jordan?
Jordan?
Hello. Is this 408?
Yes.
I'm Eddie Mason. I got a message to call.
Hello?
Paula?
Eddie? Eddie, darling, are you all right?
Well, sure I'm all right. What about you?
I love you so much.
I love you, too. I'm coming over right now. Bye, baby. Oh, I love you.
Well, let's go, then. The other girl gave us the whole bit. We'll find him.
The other girl?
Yes, the other girl.
Thank you.